And then that's Dutch in between, so you get apparently language lessons today. No. We could leave it like this and I'll be Auntie Vester again. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I feel like my camera angle is weird. But yeah, we will kind of run with it today. I don't really know. Usually I have it up higher and then facing down, and now I have it kind of, I don't know, as high as I am. It's weird. But then again, so am I. But that's not why you clicked on this video. Today, Nomad's latest palette is launching, and the destination this time is Cartagena. I am very, very fortunate this time to have it, well, actually early. Believe it or not, I have it in house since last Friday, and I kind of touched on it a little bit in the yesterday's video, my Let's Talk Makeup video, but I'm going to play with her today. The palette is cruelty free and vegan. You get 15 eyeshadow shades, and they are 1.5 grams each, I think. Does it contain talc? There doesn't seem to be any talc, but they have been sneak peeking this since, I think, last week. And yeah, today is the day. I am going to put this on my eyeballs. I will also swatch it on my arm for you, so you can kind of see the colors. What is going to happen though, but not in this video, is an eye swatch video and a multiple looks video. That is coming. I think it will be next week though, just because of what I already have planned, and I cannot push it back any further. So that is why I kind of wanted to film this one or show this one to you today, so you at least know what she kind of looks like. And she's so pretty. She's so happy. Very, very pretty, and I cannot wait to swatch her on my arm, which I'm going to do now. I have a bruise and I don't know why. I also don't know how. So yeah, we're just going to work with it. So here she is, and apparently I don't know how to swatch anymore, so there is that. But oh lordy lord, I actually think this one looks to be a satin. Let me check the shade Alpha. Yeah, it is, and I actually quite like the fact that it is. So yeah, it has a sheen. So the shade Alpha is the only satin here in the palette, and the rest are a combination of mattes and shimmers. This one is a duochrome. I think this one is as well. But knowing her, oh yeah, here's a little bit of green in. No, yeah, it's just gorgeous. I kind of wanted to play here. I kind of wanted to do that. But now I'm not sure. You know what? You saw the swatches, I don't know. I'm going to do another palette bingo, because I can, and I think that will be fun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my random number generator. I'm going to select 5 shades randomly, and I'm going to use those on my eyeballs. I always think that's fun to do. Okay, let me get my number generator, 1 to 15. Let's see if it will focus on the thing. Shade number 1 is 14. And then we have 10. Let me write that down. Okay, the next 2 and 4, and the last one is shade number 15. Okay, okay then. Okay, I wrote them down, but by not by how I drew them, but by number, if that makes sense. So we had number 2, which is the yellow shimmer, which is called Perseguir Ceños, I hope. I don't know. I don't speak this. So yeah. Then number 4 is Eres del Mundo. And then that's Dutch in between. So you get apparently language lessons today. Number 10. Let's count in Dutch then, because I can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that is Orto de Minos. Yes. Then 14. So this was 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So we have this one and this one. So it's kind of an interesting color story, I think. Huh. Yeah, it is. Wow. I have two mats. So let's start with those and I will see from there. I think that's better. I have already primed my eyes with the Sigma Eye Base, which is now finally kind of dried down a little bit after half an hour. Still don't know what I think about that one, but it does not matter. So yeah, okay. Brushes. Yes. Water. Yes. Okay. Let's start with the red. Because I can. That is the only reason. Oh, did I already say I made merch? Yeah, I said so in yesterday's video, but I made merch. So if you look in my... I'm starting with the shade called Omega. No, I was starting with the red one. And that's Orto Demonios. I hope. I don't know. It's the red. But yeah. Oh, very pigmented. But basically, I made merch. I thought it would be fun. So I did. The link is in the description box to the Teespring store. And yeah. I ordered my own merch as well, of course, because you know I need to I need to try it out myself as well. I'm very excited. As I'm filming this, it hasn't arrived yet. I hope it will arrive soon. It says that it is in printing, so yeah, I'm very very curious to see this. Huh. It's a very, very nice red, people. But then again, you know, I don't think I have a dot from them. So let me tell you a little bit about Nomad Cosmetics. Now, what is also very, very cool, I forgot to show you actually, is that they always send a card from the destination and I always handwrite it. And I just need to put them on my wall because the cards are so pretty and so inspiring. And I really like that touch, you know? So yeah, but I was talking about Nomad Cosmetics. So basically it's a couple and Antti is originally from Finland, right? Right? Yeah, I think it is. And Felicia is from the US. So yeah, they... especially Felicia, I have been talking with for quite some time, off outside of YouTube as well. She has become like family, you know, I don't know, it's just sometimes that happens. That does not mean that I will not be honest about my thoughts about the palette, by the way. Because I know that she would want me to. Or she does want me to be honest. So if I don't like if I don't like it, I will tell you. So far, the only thing that I really did not like that much was I'm looking for a brush, in case you were wondering what I'm doing. Was the fact that let's go to this one. That the first palette that I got from them, which was a present actually, was largely satins and shimmers, and there were two true mattes. So yeah, and I have said so on numerous occasions as well. I'm going to go to the shade called Omega, which was this. It's a gorgeous color. Let's put that here and blend out the red a little bit with that. So I do have a discount code with them. It is listed down in the description box. And as I said, or at least I think I did, this was PR. But still, if it hadn't been PR, I would have bought it anyway. Because I love the color story. I love the way that this looks. And I know that I really, really love their formula. And the mattes are, they don't swatch the best, as you saw. But they are very, very easy to work with. Usually they blend very, very nicely together without really blending away. And they should also have, at least on their Instagram, swatches. Or they should be up or they are coming off deeper skin tones. Because I also know that Audra, from Audra at Home, I will link her channel down below. She was at least the swatching model for the Orient Express. And I believe that she will swatch this one as well. So that you can see it on the darker skin tone. But looking at how vibrant these colors are and how rich, I think it will be okay. And I don't know if I'm correct though, but it could very well be that this shade Alpha, which is the lightest shade here in the palette, is a satin because of that. Because of, at least I think so, that satins are not ashy as quickly on a darker skin tone. Correct me if I'm wrong though, because yeah, obviously, I don't know. I'm just throwing something out there, actually. Okay, I'm going back to the first brush. And I'm going to blend the two together a little bit. And then I'm going to build up the red with the brush I just used. The smaller one. Now, there is kick up in the pan. And I'm patting it on my eye carefully because, yeah, otherwise I will probably get fallout. Not that I mind that too much. But yeah, if I can avoid it, I will. It's not that it is very, very, I don't know, it's not ABH powderiness or kick-upiness, but there is kick-up. And I usually like a bit of kick-up in my eyeshadows because that just means that I get a lot of pigment. I don't have to dig my brush in as much. And usually color payoff is very, very nice. And I know that that is the way that these mattes work. We could leave it like this and I'll be Auntie Fester again. I can do that, yes. Okay, I think I have an idea. I'm grabbing a flat brush, but no glitter primer yet. I will, but not quite yet. Because I want the hot pink, which is called La Luz Malva. Do you say the Z at the end of a word in Spanish? I think it's what they... what they speak in Cartagena, I actually don't know. But I'm going to put the hot pink here. Because I want to connect it to my lower lash line. But I don't want the hot pink to be too hot pink, if that makes... it does not make sense, but it makes sense in my head. I want it to flow with the color that I have in the crease and in the outer corner. That is why I'm putting it on top dry. It's very cutesy. But I want it underneath my eye as well. And I want a hot pink lower lash line. Do I have a hot pink? Is that hot pink enough? Probably not. But I think it's what I have. Yeah, it will do. So I have here from Colourpop the shade Boots. But it's in a pot. I'm going to put that in the lash line. And or waterline, I don't know. And on my bottom lid, I'm going to stamp it as well. Then I'm going to put that shimmer that I just used on top. With a small brush. I'm going to spray the shimmer a little bit with a little bit of water so that it sticks to my brush a bit better and it doesn't land on my cheeks. And I'm going to put it a little bit just with this brush here. So that I can kind of connect everything. Okay, let's then go to the red. Just a tiny bit.
And then this.
Wow, that sounded very, very... yeah, that's fun. Okay. Now... besides taking a sip of water, I'm going to grab my NYX Glitter Primer as well. And a flat brush. I'm putting a tiny bit... oh, that's a little... that's a lot, but... it's probably for two eyes, but I have some here. And I'm just going to place it on my lid first a little bit, and then I'm going to stretch my eye. And follow my eyeball. And clean up the lid. And then here in the beginning, I want it a little bit higher than my actual eyeball. I'm going to put the two other shimmers on my eyeball. I'm first going to go to Eres El Mundo, this one. And then I'm going to grab that one. Ew. My eyelids are sticking together, which is kind of weird. Yay! So let's put this on the eye first. Ooh, that's nice. And because I'm patting it on top of a glitter primer now, everything sticks where I place it, so it's more opaque. But looking at this, and especially at the swatch, you can very nicely play with it. With the opaqueness, I mean. It's going to go a little bit diagonally because I like that. Oh, it's such a pretty shade, this. And almost, it could be wrong though. It could be because I'm using it in conjunction with the shades that I have already on my eyes. But it looks to have a little bit of an orangey sparkle in there as well. I don't know though. It looks to have a little bit of extraness. Which is usually the case with their shades. Okay, now I'm going to go to that other color. What I don't know, is that a chartreuse? I have no idea. Ooh, that's nice. I have no idea what kind of color this is, really. I'm going to pull it on top of that other shade. Okay, I'm going to also go to that hot pink again. I want to mix that a little bit with that middle shade. Nice. Okay, I'm going to go to that, well, basically the the pinky shimmer, but with a fluffier brush. Let's see what happens when I blend that a little bit in the crease. So basically I'm cheating, as I usually am. I want the crease a little bit more pink. So let's see if that, yeah, a tiny bit, and that's good. So I'm playing a little bit more with that base shade now. I do have fallout though, just so you know. I do kind of like this. I think this is cutesy. Inner corner highlight. You know what? I'm just going to grab my face highlighter, which is also from Nomad. It's from their Studio 54 collection. It's the shade Disco Nights. Did I say that I also have it on my face? I love to use this underneath blush and then basically create a shimmery blush. Okay, then I'm going to go into that the shade that I have there. I'm going to tap it on top a little bit and then connect it a little bit with the bottom so it flows a little bit nicer. This is it for the eyes, guys. I really like it. Maybe I can even spruce up my blush a little bit extra. Where's my glitter? There. Can I? Yeah, probably. Is it handy? Probably not. I'm going to go into the center shade. I will show it to you in just a second. With my blush brush. And I'm very lightly dusting it on my cheeks. I thought my camera stopped recording because half an hour was done and I was like, you know what, let me just finish off the face. So that is what I did. Let me first show you the blush shade that I used. It's actually the middle shade called Realismo Magico. Magico? I don't know. This one. Just very, very lightly. And I do think it complements everything very, very nicely. But yeah, here is the completed look. Done with the Cartagena palette from Nomad Cosmetics. I really like how the look came together. Yeah, I really, really do. On my lips is a combination between the lip stain from Odense Eye Cosmetics in the shade Ripe Papaya. And a little bit of gloss from Catrice Generation Plump and Shine in the shade Glowing Tourmaline. I like the color of the stain. I just really don't know if it suits me. When I look in the mirror, I think, ooh, that's cute. And then when I see myself back on camera, I'm like, nee. I don't know. So that's why I put a gloss on top. It could just be the color, or maybe it's just between my ears. I don't know. Falsies are from Primark in the style Paris. Yes. I really like the color story of this one. I like the outside of the palette. I like the whole aesthetic. And I love the fact that it is a little bit of a muted color story, but still with bright colors in there. For instance, this yellow, which is almost a neon-y. Is this a chartreuse? I don't know. When I look at it, it is yellow, but with a hint of green in it as well. I really like these colors, these types of colors. And then these two together give it that little bit of extra pop. But also this one, while it looks a little bit muted, if you swatch it, it's a very nice, vibrant pink with these as well. So the color story is a little bit muted on the one hand. And on the other hand, it is vibrant and fun and summery. And, you know, I'm looking at it now through the mirror. I am seeing looks that I want to do. If you want to keep it light, you can do the first row, you know, have a little bit more pastels. And again, this is a satin, which I think, although would I want this as a matte? Not really. If I'm thinking about how I build up my eye looks, and this specific color, if I were to use this to blend out, for instance, this color, it usually does not look very good. So if I want to blend out this color, I either use just this color. I could also use this one or just my face powder. But I think that, especially to make it more versatile for more skin tones, I think it is great that she made this one a satin. And I actually think that it would be really pretty to put it on the lid. So this in the crease, maybe deepen it up with this a tiny bit if you want to. And then this one on the lid and then this one in the inner corner. I think that will be a very, very pretty look. So yeah, I cannot wait to play with this more, guys. This was the first impression. I cannot wait to see how the shadows perform when I pack them on my eyeballs as well. So that is coming. The eye swatch video is coming. Multiple looks video is coming as well. But I just really wanted to have a video up today to show you guys what the palette looks like. And I think that it is the Nomad formula that I have come to know. I have never had any issues with their mattes or with their shimmers. So yeah, it's just one of my favorite brands, and it is for a very, very good reason, or I think so. And that is going to be it for today's video. Let me know down below what you think of this look. What you think of the palette? Are you excited? Are you grabbing it? I will leave their site down below, and my discount code will be there as well, which gives you 10% off, and it's not affiliated. But let me know, are you excited about this? Do you like this? Are you skipping it? Let me know down in the comment section. Let's chat about it. Don't forget to check out the description box for the rest of the makeup that I have on my face. And then that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one, which will be tomorrow. Bye, guys. Your neck. Yeah, mine does also, kinda. I was mixing today, so there's that.